There are many ways to do this, but let's look at how to sidechain the old school way with a compressor and a trigger. This method is particularly useful if you have a beat that's not 4 to the floor. I'll show you how to sidechain using various plugins later in the video. I'll explain how to set it up and when to use it. Let's create a basic kick and bass pattern. Volume ducking, or sidechaining as most people call it, is one of the most important mixing tools available to you as a producer. Technically, sidechaining can be used for a lot of things, but it's most commonly used for volume ducking. So whenever someone tells you to sidechain something, they're usually referring to volume ducking. Sidechain compression would be a more correct term, but I'll get back to that in a bit. If you don't know anything about sidechaining or why we use it, then I recommend you watch my other video about that first, and then come back to this one afterwards. By now, hopefully, you have already watched my other video about what sidechaining is and why we use it. So let's cut to the chase and set up some actual sidechaining. Assign the kick to mixer track 1, and then the bass to track 2. Now, there will always be some overlap between these two, and that's what we want to avoid. If several low-end elements overlap, it will make the mix sound muddy or muffled, and you don't want that. Most beginners end up with tracks that sound muddy, and this is one of the main reasons why. So let's set up some basic sidechain compression for this. I recommend using a dedicated sidechain trigger and not the main kick itself. You could, in theory, use the kick itself as a trigger, but that would become impractical in many situations. So let's just clone the main kick instead, like so, rename it, and assign it to another mix insert. Left-click here. Give it a name and a color. It's important to stay organized. Now, if you press play, you'll notice that the kick is much louder. That's because it's duplicated. So let's mute the cloned kick by disconnecting it from the master. Left-click here. Now with the sidechain track selected, find the bass track and right-click here. Select sidechain to this track. Next, add the fruity limiter to the bass track. Go to the compressor section and then right-click here. Select the sidechain trigger we just created. Let's set a ratio. This determines how much compression will be applied when the signal goes above the threshold. You can now lower the threshold until you notice that it starts ducking the volume. You can fine-tune the effect by adjusting the attack and release settings as well. If I adjust the threshold, the effect becomes even more evident. You can also try something like this. I'm just going to tweak this a little bit. A good rule of thumb is to apply heavy sidechaining to low-frequency elements, such as your bass. As you go up in frequency, you can apply less and less sidechaining. These days, most people just use LFOtool, Kickstart, and so on, and that works very well most of the time. As long as you have a standard 4-to-the-floor beat going on, you won't have any problems. When you have a more advanced beat, or if you want to sidechain something such as a melody, you will need to use the old school method with a trigger and a compressor. This is just one of the reasons why old school sidechaining can be so useful. Now that our sidechain trigger is in place, we can use the same method to sidechain other elements in the mix. The procedure will be exactly the same, and you can use the same trigger, so this only needs to be set up once. If you remove the trigger from anywhere in the track, you'll essentially disable all the sidechaining during that part. And that's one reason why it's better to have a separate sidechain trigger. This is the old school way of sidechaining, and it'll work on everything. Plugins like LFOtool, Kickstart, etc. can also be used. Just load the plugin on whatever you want to sidechain and adjust the envelope accordingly. Let's add the LFOtool to get some volume ducking. This is much quicker and will usually work well as long as it's a standard 4-to-the-floor beat. But again, it's not as versatile as real sidechaining with a compressor and a trigger. Some elements, such as vocals and leads, will usually sound better without any sidechaining at all, unless you're going for a pumping effect. Alan Walker's music is a good example of this. You can clearly hear that pumping effect by the sidechaining in all his tracks. Even the main leads will tend to be heavily sidechained, kind of like this. It's what gives it that pumping effect. Without sidechaining, it will sound very different. I have several other videos about sidechaining, so if you want to know more tips and tricks about sidechaining, then check out the links in the description below. Feel free to check out some of these videos as well. And as always, if you have a question, just let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching.